G'day guys, back again. Hope you're doing well, all things considered. Again, if you saw my last video, I was just showing you a couple of kits that I'd found in my dungeon that I came across, which I sort of forgot I had. This is another one of those kits. So I thought we'd have a quick look at this one just inside, and God knows what we're looking at here. I actually get that quite a bit with some of my kits. People say that they didn't get the instructions with their kit. I've had that about three or four times where people have asked me to send them the instructions. So that's kind of like why I do the video with the instructions actually in my video now. And how good is this? I mean, look how quick this goes together. By jingos, that's five steps. There's not a lot of models that you get where it's all done in 5 steps. As you can see, there's still a couple of little handles to go on. A couple of these, Star Wars stuff, love these type of gas canister types, World War II shapes. They love that stuff. And whoever designed this kit, I'm going to put it out there, wasn't a figure lover, because you cannot design a kit with a hatch and have the hatch closed. I mean, that is really annoying. You need to have a hatch open. Just so, I mean, even if you sculpted your own figure, you know, found another figure from a, I don't know, Micro Machines set or whatever, you know, one of those. I think Star Wars did release some plastic figures around close. It was close to 132 scale. Might be about 5 or 6 little sets of stormtroopers and stuff like that together. Can't remember exactly, but one of those might fit in there. It's pretty basic going together here. That's pretty much the busiest step, which really isn't a busy step at all. And then you've got your gun goes on top. And I just cannot believe that they just didn't give you a figure with this. Even that by itself, without even putting the base part on it, is quite an interesting design. I mean, it almost looks like a spaceship on its own, just this part here. Flip it over. You've got all your little colours. And you get a Star Wars base. You must get decals, are they, I'm guessing? Or what's F? Well, I don't know what F is. We'll have to have a look. Let's have a look. No, I did see the base, but I must have left it down in the dungeon. I can't actually see any decals in the kit. So, I think that's just saying, I got you now. Oh, yeah, I got you. This F is just for the F up here, for light grey. Here I was thinking it was a decal, but no, it's not. And the G, we'll be guessing it was for white, for Star Wars, which makes sense. Although I always thought Star Wars sometimes is in that yellowy, goldy colour as well, but there you go. It's actually a pretty decent sized kit. If we bring up my ruler here, my kangaroo ruler's gone on quarantine. He's locked up down at the moment. So this one's roughly, it's got to be close to almost dead on 30 centimetres there. Or what's that? Is that about a foot? I think it's about a foot. And I suppose we can do the width. The width is roughly around 25 centimetres. As you can see, it's a pretty large size solid kit, really. I mean, always reminds you of sort of different things when you start building these kits. I don't know if you're a bit of a kit basher or a sci-fi guy, but sometimes I look at these things and you start thinking, oh, that could almost be something like a Slave One Boba Fett shit if I tipped it up like that, or something like that, or put a cockpit up here, and you start thinking about kit bashing some kits. But as a tank, a hover tank I call it, it's got some really nice, I don't know if you can see it there, there's quite a lot of nice rivets, actually, that they're quite well defined all the way down around the tank there. My glue's not holding up too well on this kit either. If you saw my last video, it's gone a little bit yellow. I've used this for years, this stuff, this Revell stuff. I'm pretty sure that's what I would have glued this down with. So over the years, it obviously turns a bit of a yellow colour, I'm guessing. Because that's the same glue I used on my other kit, the Omega kit that I had in my last video. So that's a bit quite interesting that it turns that colour. And as you can see, you do get a nice lovely little seam line that runs all the way down the kit. And this must be one of the kits I was talking about with the Tamiya putty I tried to use. And also at the back here. And I think there's another seam line, maybe around here where the kit joins. The actual bottom there, this sort of bottom plate is glued on, and you can probably see what I was talking about with the old Tamiya paint. It's a bit thick there, and I didn't really know about the whole thinning thing, in one of my other videos I've just done. So and even here you can almost see where it's, the putty's actually cracked. And but I actually did drop this, so this might have actually cracked when I dropped it, which would probably make a lot of sense. Let's see, it goes in here. See this, I think it sort of locks in place a little bit. And you can sort of slap that on there like that. And you can sort of see, it's a pretty cool design. I actually really do like this design. As far as Star Wars goes, I think this is a cracker of design in one of their movies. Some of the, and some of the stuff in the Clone Wars that they have is absolutely fantastic. And in the actual comic itself, really love some of the stuff in the comics. And I think this must have, obviously, you can see there again, nice big seam line running all the way down there and around the kit here and pretty much all around there. So a bit of putting to do if you want to take it seriously. But how hard would it have been? I mean, I know they're saving because they'd have to do an extra part to just have that part open up like a normal tank hatch. That's a bit disappointing. And as you can see, probably from the front here, I did end up dropping it. And just the front part of the barrel sort of broke off. No other pieces of the plastic's missing. So it's kind of a clean break in a way. And you also get the, whatever you call these, the side guns that go on the side. Something like that. AMT kit goes. I think this is a cracker of one. I actually really rate this model. And, you know, as long as you're prepared to, if you're just a beginner, it doesn't matter. You don't need to fill up all the seam lines. You can just leave it the way it is and enjoy the build. And the other thing with this is, I mean, you could just paint this so many different colours, you know. I don't know if these are in the Clone Wars. I don't know if they have the different colours in the Clone Wars, but you could certainly paint these pretty much whatever colour you like, really. The only downfall for me is that you don't get a little, what is it? You know, your little droid, your Roger. Your Roger droid. That's the only downfall. It'd be nice to have him where you could just have him standing on the tank there. As you know, I like figures just to show its scale. But, yeah, really like it. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.